Hey everybody, it's Justin and we're hanging out again in my pit lane garage doing more work to my 2017 Subaru BRZ. This time we're actually demodifying the car, or maybe remodifying, something like that. I'm actually going to be changing out an upgrade that I installed about 2 weeks or so ago. And the part we're talking about is actually the Grimmspeed intake here in the engine bay. So what we're going to do is put the stock airbox back in. I've got that sitting up here. It's already pretty efficient as it is and works good. It doesn't soak up heat, being that it's made out of a plastic type of material. Along with the stock airbox, we're actually going to be installing a pair and inlet tube to get rid of the sound tube portion of the air intake, and also a high flow K&N air filter. So we're going to get this old Grimmspeed intake box off of the car, install the original stock airbox, and then I'll show you the new pair and inlet tube and the K&N filter. Grimmspeed airbox is now taken out, sitting right behind Shelby here. Gonna be replacing that box again with the bone stock airbox from the car. We'll also be installing the Perrin inlet tube, which is this rubber guy here. And what that does is actually replaces the stock inlet tube with this big resonator on it, and also the sound tube. So we get rid of that junk with the Perrin inlet tube. To finish things off, we're going to throw in a high flow K&N air filter to replace the stock filter that comes in the car, and that should just about complete this remodification. So real quick, while the airbox is still out of the car, we'll show you how to put the air filter in that we've got. Basically, you've got a couple clips on the top of the airbox. Those just flip up and then we can access the air filter. It's a little more tricky when it's inside the car, obviously, but it's still not too bad. We got our stock filter element, just pops right out. So we'll take our new K&N filter, go ahead and drop it in there.
It might still, when you get out of the packaging, it might still be a little greasy.
So one thing I learned while filming this video is that the K&N filter that I got is actually not the right part, only for the 2017 manual transmission cars. So this is part number 332300. So this particular drop-in air filter fits every single BRZ, FRS, and 86 made, even the 2017 automatic transmission cars. It does not fit the 2017 manual transmission cars. So I've got to go get a different filter. I've got it ordered up. I'll let you guys know when I get that in. I'll do another video of an airbox swap, or an air filter swap, while the airbox is still in the car. I'm going to continue the video. Even though I don't have the K&N in there, I'm still going to reference the K&N filter, and then we'll go through getting the airbox and everything put back in the car. So we got the air filter in the airbox. We can now go ahead and throw the airbox into the car. So installing the stock airbox back to the car is pretty simple. One thing I had to do, obviously, is swap over the MAF sensor from the old Grimmspeed intake back onto this one. Once you line up the snorkel over here on the right side, it's just a few screws to get everything tied down. So grab my Perrin inlet hose with the hose clamps on it. Pretty much just slide it over the airbox inlet and then the throttle body. Then we'll work on getting the hose clamps lined up and the hoses lined up. Oops. Next, we'll take the little vacuum line that attaches to the back of the parent hose here. And we'll tighten up the three bolts on the airbox and we're done. So that's gonna wrap it up for this video, demodifying the air intake system and then remodifying the air intake system. If you're interested in the parts that I use, I'll leave them down in the description below. And as always, if you have any thoughts or comments, I'd love to hear from you. Please leave those below as well. Thanks everybody for watching. I really appreciate it. I will talk to you all next time.